Well, our next guest starred in 90s classics like Clueless, Beverly Hills 90210, and Sabrina the Teenage Witch, and now she's writing a tell-all. Elisa Donovan joins us now, whatever, about her new memoir. I had to get one of those in there. Good morning, Elisa. How are you?
I'm doing well, thanks. How are you? You know, you're not the first person to do that to me. I will let you know.
I don't think there's a first for anything anymore with Google and the internet and social media, which is kind of a bummer.
It's true.
Okay, I do want to ask you something that maybe not a lot of interviewers would ask you. Going back to Sabrina and the Teenage Witch, okay, I'm a huge cat lover, and I actually know Nick McKay because he plays fantasy football. Yeah, so will you tell me one little story about how that all works when you guys are filming with a talking cat?
Yes, yes. First of all, Nick is so terrific. He is hilarious and very brilliant, but also just a really good guy. So when we're actually shooting with the animatronic cat,
yeah,
a lot of people involved in operating that cat. The cat's got a team. But the actual recording of the voice, I think the first couple of years when I was not there, Nick used to be on set because he was a writer on the show as well. And so he would be reading it live on set, but then he started to do Sabrina and another show. And so they would have someone just read the cat's lines. So I missed out having Nick be with us every day.
Right.
So I only got to see him, you know, once a week or something.
Yeah. I was geeking out on him when, during fantasy football draft, when I found out he was there and he was the voice, I wound up taking a picture with him and like all the other celebrities that were there at the draft, I didn't care about. So that was my geeking out moment.
He was the one.
Yeah.
He's the one.
Yeah. Okay. You've done so much. And now you made this book titled Wake Me Up When You Leave. All right. I know you don't want to give a lot of things away because you want people to buy the book, obviously. But what are a couple tidbits? I mean, we love the TV shows that you were in.
So this book is not really about the TV shows. Mm-hmm. However, it is about this period of my life where Sabrina was ending. And well, was canceled.
Right.
And my dad got cancer, and the relationship that I was in with the person I thought I was going to marry ended.
Wow.
So essentially my whole life just was turned upside down, and I went from knowing or thinking I knew where my life was going and who I was and what was happening to just having everything stripped away. And it was an incredibly challenging period of my life. And the book is about that period and how I came through it and recovered and went through the grief process of losing my dad. Mm. And the title, Wake Me When You Leave, refers to my dad coming to me in these dreams, visitation dreams, where he really helped me to heal and remedy my life. And then it also refers to, you know, once he left, I sort of woke up to my life.
Well, like as much as we love the 90s shows and the shows that you've been in, that actually has more value to it. And we can relate to those types of issues even more. So thank you for writing that book. And you know, we can talk to you forever, but we'll move on, we'll pay some bills. And in the meantime, all the information is on your screen on where you can grab that book, Wake Me Up When You Leave. Thanks, Elisa.
Thank you, thanks so much.